All is well, dear students. Welcome again. In the previous video, we have studied about primary memory. Now, in this video, we are going to learn about secondary memory. So, students, we know that primary memory is also known as main memory. Primary memory is directly accessed by the CPU. We cannot store large amount of data in the primary memory. So, secondary memory is available for bulk storage of data. So first I will explain you what is secondary memory. Secondary memory is also called auxiliary memory, external memory or backup memory. The data that has to be permanently stored is kept in secondary memory. The CPU cannot directly access the data in secondary memory. The data has to be initially copied to primary memory, then only it can be processed by CPU. On other hand, primary memory can be directly accessed by the CPU. Secondary memory is used for bulk storage of programs, data and other information. It has much larger capacity than the primary memory. Data accessing speed of secondary memory is slower than primary memory. The secondary memory is non-volatile in nature, which means that the data is stored permanently even when the power of the computer is switched off. Secondary memory is the slowest and cheapest form of memory. Secondary memory may also be called secondary storage or mass storage media. Some commonly used devices for secondary storage are hard disk, CD, DVD, pen drive and memory card. So let's discuss these devices in detail. The hard disk is the main secondary storage device within a computer. It can store large amount of data and it is used to store user data permanently. Hard disk is a non-volatile memory. You can see that in the diagram. A hard disk consists of a spindle that hold one or more disk called platters. The platters are coated with a thin layer of magnetic material and data is written on them with the help of read-write head. A hard disk can store several gigabytes of data and it is used for storing applications and files for a user. CD stands for compact disk. CD are known as optical storage devices. A compact disk can store approximately 700 MB of data. A laser beam is used for storing data on the disk. Compact disk can be of two types, CDR and CDRW. CDR is called recordable CD. Data once recorded on CDR cannot be erased. CDRW is called rewritable CD. Data stored on the CDRW can be erased and new data can be stored in its place. DVD stands for digital video disc or digital versatile disc. A DVD is also an optical storage device like the CD. Laser beam technique is used to store and read the data. A DVD can store much more data than a CD. A single-sided DVD can store about 4.7 GB of data. DVDs which store data on both sides can hold over 9 GB of data. Next very popular device is pen drive. A pen drive is a storage device that is small in size and can be carried easily. It is a USB device that can be used to quickly transfer audio, video and data files from the hard drive of one computer to another. A pen drive uses flash memory. Flash memory is a technology that allows data to be electrically stored, erased and reprogrammed. Another popular device is memory card. A memory card is a type of storage device that is used for storing media and data files. A memory card is a form of flash memory. Memory card is small in size and can store data in digital format. Memory cards are commonly used in small portable devices such as mobile phones, digital cameras, MP3 players, tablet and many other portable devices. So dear students, I hope you have understood the concept of secondary memory. I will coming soon with new chapter and new topic. Till that time, bye bye. Take care, stay home and stay safe.